Hello everyone, in this class today let us try to understand on the topic of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, that is AIIB, its objectives and structure. It has been prescribed for BA program for the third semester under Mangalore University in the subject of Monetary Economics. Myself, Dr. Srinivas Iyya, Department of Collegiate Education, Government of Karnataka. Learning objective of this course, this session is to the concept of Asian Development Bank, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. By the learners, they will understand the concept. Session outcome, it helps the students to understand what is AIIB. It helps students to understand how AIIB came into force and what are their objectives. Helps students to understand objectives and organizational structure of AIIB. Further, my presentation plan, the introduction of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, origin of AIIB, meaning of AIIB, objectives of AIIB, membership and management of AIIB. Introduction. In the introductory part of the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank is a multilateral development bank that aims to improve economic and social outcome in Asia. The bank currently has 103 members as well as 21 prospective members from around the world. The headquarters of this AIIB is located Beijing, China. Region third Asia and Oceania. That is, the purpose is crediting and members are 103 countries. It has been formulated 16th January in 2016. This is the introductory part of that is Asia's Infrastructure Investment Bank, which is promoted by China. The origin of AIIB, China's leader Xi Jinping first proposed the Asian Infrastructure Bank at the APEC summit in Bali in 2013. AIIB was launched at the ceremony of Beijing in October 2014 to begin operations in January 2016 and have now grown to the extent of 103 approved members worldwide, which means it begins operations from January 2016 onwards, and it was launched in the year 2014. Meaning of AIIB, it is a new international development bank that provides financing for infrastructure projects in Asia. It has been established for the purpose of infrastructure projects. That is, Jim Lukian is the current president of AIIB. This is the meaning part we need to understand. Further, what are the objectives of AIIB? Sustainable infrastructure, promoting green infrastructure and supporting members to meet their environmental and developmental goals. Cross-border connectivity, prioritizing the cross-border infrastructure ranging from roads to rail and ports, energy pipelines, telecom across Asian countries, which means across the Asian countries, it is going to fund the cross-border connectivity, private capital mobilization, devising innovative solutions that capitalizes private capital partnership with MDB governments, that is private financiers for other parents. So this is the objectives of AIIB: sustainable infrastructure, that is cross-border connectivity, private capital mobilization, membership and management of AIIB. On 24th October 2014, there were 21 countries signed a Memorandum of Understanding, MOU, regarding AIIB in Beijing. As of, that is 16th May, that is 2020, total number of countries approved for the members are 103, which means it has been started with the 21 countries. Now the number of countries has been increased to 103 countries. Regional members, 45, non-regional members, 31 members, prospective members, 21 members. India became part of this from 11th January 2016. It is governed and accountable to the member countries, that is AIIB. It is governed and accountable for its member countries in all the way. So therefore, we can say that AIIB, it is one of the important institution, that is a banker which provides loan facility for its member countries in the form of infrastructure loan. Further, management of AIIB. The management of AIIB is Board of Governors, Board of Directors, and Senior Management Team, International Advisory Panel. So, AIIB, Board of Governors are there, Directors are there, that is management teams are there, and advisory panels are there. So, this is the management team of AIIB. Further, management of AIIB, the Board of Governors, it is the main organ of the AIIB. Every board, every member of country appoints one governor and one alternative governor. Meeting will be conducted annually. Board of Governors, Board of Directors, the Board of Governors will elect these directors. It is responsible for the directions of general operations. So therefore, we can say that the Board of Directors are also equally important in managing the AIIB day-to-day operations. Next, senior management team. The senior management team, that is, includes president, vice president, and general counsel. So the international advisory panel. So the bank established an international advisory panel to help advise the president, senior management on bank strategies, policies, as well as on general operational issues. So therefore, we can say that international advisory panel will also be there. This international advisory panel will advise AIIB to invest and creation of infrastructure fund on behalf of its member countries at the various stages. Management of AIIB. President is the topmost management of the AIIB. He is the present governor, Board of Directors, topmost official of AIIB, person a long experience, ethical integrity in banking, economics and finance, will be considered for the post of president, responsible for day-to-day administration, hire and fire staff of the policies. He can appoints vice presidents and reduce the workload, which means he is the top person of the management. He can do better many things, while appointing the president, there are many things has been, integrity has been considered, experience has been considered, and so that is in the field of economics, banking, finance has been taken into an important task. Resources of AIIB, the starting capital bank was $100 billion, which is equal to 2/3 of ADB, and it is about half of the World Bank. That was the starting capital, and it is China willing to give 50% of that, which means the ADB, AIIB total capital, 50% of its China is willing to give. The see next shareholding to the decided on GDP adjustment for purchasing power parity shareholding pattern for its member countries will be decided on the basis of GDP shareholding purchasing power parity according to China, the largest, and India is the second largest shareholder of this project, that is Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. India and China and India are the largest shareholders of this bank. Conclusion, to say conclude of this bank, that is Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, an important role Asia and Oceania's infrastructure development for its member countries. So as a result, all other economic activities will be encouraged on the basis of creation of good infrastructure. As a result, industry will be developed, agriculture will be developed, all other trade will be developed. So therefore, a more flow of money will come, more investment will come, then the standard of living enhances, then as a result, the employment generates. Like this, the AIIB, it is going to help its member countries in many ways. So this is the way a references has been made. So you can go through that, and MCQs, and how many members are there in AIIB at currently, which has been, so that is which already have been mentioned, you need to be keep in mind, which I have already 103 is the answer. Next, who holds the presidential post of AIIB currently? So that is second one you need to be, that is Jin Likwan, you are required to be keep in mind. Next, third one, where is the AIIB headquarters are located? You need to be keeping mind, that is Beijing. Obviously, it is being funded by China. When is the AIIB was established? So that is obviously it is on October 2014, which has been mentioned. Which is the main organ, Board of Governors, which I already told. Answer is A. In this connection, all of you read well myself, so that is you can go through that all the slides and listen to it carefully and subscribe the channel, do better. Thank you, my dear all.